So, right at the beginning, those two on the TV, they had to be the rivals, right? Like, they wouldn't show them twice in this episode if they weren't gonna be the rivals. I really like their designs. This, like, really tall, graceful-looking, like, hair-streak babe and this little chicken gremlin. I love them both. I think they're really cool, and I hope they're the rivals because they have... Oh, their designs are so distinct, and I'm so starved of that. In Love Live, like, we all know that it suffers so badly from same face syndrome, and the reason that I get attached to characters like Yoshiko is because it's like, oh wow, they have such big personalities. But these two, I just hope that their personalities reflect their designs, because they are very cool and I want to know more about them. I'm assuming that they are Sunipa, and that's cool. That's all I really got to go off at the moment, but hopefully we get to see them more. Fingers crossed. So the intro song is very cute, but I don't remember if I mentioned this last time, but I'm getting a lot of like emotional whiplash from all of these scenes of the five girls being friends and doing idol stuff, and then we go to the actual story and like we still don't know what Sumire's deal is. Like, what was she doing? What was she actually doing when she had like cream on her nose? I don't know. I get the idea that she's maybe like some kind of social media influencer or wants to be an influencer and was trying to get attention. Maybe she thinks that she's really popular, but she's actually not, which like same, but I want to know more about her. She seems like an absolute dork, and just when this happens, when a show introduces a character that I think I'm really gonna like and then we don't see them much in the first couple of episodes, I get a bit bored. Superstar hasn't done that to me yet. I'm still very interested. I still really like Kanon. She's very cool. Tang was better in this episode. I think her voice when she's serious is so much better than when she gets all overexcited, because that's when she dips back into Ubu territory. When she was talking about Ren, and I mean, I don't know if this is an official translation, but when she calls Ren a little bitch, that's fantastic. Love that. Love the savagery. But the fact that Ren and Tang are both so ruthless, like Ren in her stance on school idols and her sort of, I guess, her overprotection of the school and its reputation, and then Tang protecting her goals and her ideas. Like, I love that juxtaposition. I can see these two clashing heads a lot, and I love that. I love when the characters get angry at one another, and when we have that kind of emotional conflict, it makes the story so much better instead of just, oh, you know, they're all friends and they all get along. Like, ugh, boring. I need more. I need more story substance than just they're all friends. And so far, Superstar's given that to me. Kanon and Tang have been very quick to become friends, which is fine. Like, the story itself is moving very quickly. We've already covered a lot in two episodes. And, you know, that's right. I think that the pacing is fine. It could, if they keep this up, it's gonna go way too quickly. Like, I did feel that a lot of parts in Muse's anime were very drawn out, very slow. So maybe they're trying to do something different with this one. It's hard to tell, but we'll just have to see. I really liked that little scene with Chisato walking down the street doing those little dance moves, and also the little music cues, that whole like Ren's weakness is, her weakness is nothing. I really liked that scene. That was cool. I did really like that we got a lot more Chisato in this episode. Her supportiveness is contagious, and I really, really like her. Compared to Kanon and Tang, she does seem a bit bland, so I'm hoping that we get a bit more of just like Chisato as herself and not as the supportive best friend, because there's got to be more to her. Like, we've seen there's a lot to Kanon. Like, we've seen her as a sort of like happy but distant person in public, and then she's really snappy at her family. We've seen this side of Tang where she's so passionate and just wants to go for every single goal she's got, but she's also not very athletic and didn't consider that that might be a problem when trying to be an idol. Like, we saw that with obviously Honoka and Haneo, and it's a good plot point. It gives us conflict. It gives us a problem to overcome. We're already seeing some characters fit into the typical archetypes. So obviously Chisato being a choreographer and Kanon being the composer, which I really, really like. I love that we got the composer right off the bat and the protagonist didn't have to go looking for one. It feels like the writers have given these guys a little bit more. They don't have to go looking for as many things. Like obviously with Tang just having song lyrics ready to go and Kanon being able to write music to it, that gives them more opportunity to focus on other plot points. In this case, the training with Chisato. Those montages are very cute. I did like how at the end we saw Tang taking initiative and just putting her goals first and saying, no, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna get better, and it's gonna be fun, I'm gonna have fun doing it. And Kanon joining her at the end was so cute. I think these two have a really good dynamic, and there's a lot here. There's more to Kanon and Tang than there is to Kanon and Chisato, which seems a bit odd because we know that Chisato and Kanon have been, like, I guess childhood friends? I'm pretty sure they were childhood friends, but at the moment it just kind of feels like Chisato is there to support Kanon and not actually be her own character, so I'm waiting for the Chisato episode. Ren was also very good in this episode. We sort of got a reiteration of the kind of aloof, distant, very dedicated character that she is. We got a bit of a hint at the importance of her mother. I think, you know, it's gonna be typical, like, oh, she's very important with the school, and I personally don't really care for those kind of plot lines. I don't think that they add much to the series as a whole. Still, it'll be interesting to see where that all leads. Obviously, it's something she takes very seriously, and I get why she was so against the others pursuing school idols and the whole, like, oh, our school's reputation, like, if you do a really bad job, then you're gonna ruin it because you're not in the music course. I understand that, and I think that that's a great source of conflict, because one thing that Superstar is doing very well is breaking away from the whole school is shutting down plot. Like, it's a fine plot point, but to do it three times in a row would just feel like a cop-out, and I'm really glad that they're not doing it three times in a row. And obviously they're trying to do new things with the plot, and so far I don't have any complaints. I think it's going well. The pacing's very quick. I really hope we get slower episodes coming up, because trying to retain all the information from these episodes and then talk about it is not my strong suit. I actually took notes for this one. They're very bad notes, but you know, it's difficult to write things down and read subtitles at the same time. I just want to reiterate the point that having all of these musical interludes where the girls are hanging out together and they're doing idol activities, and we see these relationships forming, but like, I don't think Tang and Sumire have even met yet. Ren is certainly not going to just start hanging out with the others. That's definitely not going to happen. I think it would make more sense if in episode one we had a song with Kanon and Tang hanging out, and then episode two they add Chisato, and then they slowly add more as more girls join the group. Like, we don't know how Ren and Sumire are going to get involved, and Ren is probably going to be the last one to join. My guess is that probably Tang will approach Sumire and be like, hey, do you want to be an idol? And Sumire will be like, no, but also yes, because I want to be popular. I'm pretty sure that'll be her driving force, is that she wants to be really popular, whether that's online or like as a celebrity or something. I will put money on that being the case. Design-wise, Kanon's very cute with her fringe up. I like that they're doing that kind of thing with the characters this time. Like, we're seeing them in a more relaxed light, and that's really cool. I love seeing that side of them. Also, just any character that wears glasses is an A+ in my book. The intro song is very cool. I actually saw the outfits on Twitter before I watched the episode. The outfits are fine. They're not what I'd usually go for. I'm very fussy when it comes to houndstooth, but that's what happens when you're a fashion designer. I think the songs are so far, like, they're the kind of things that we've seen from the beginning albums of all the Loveload groups in the past, these kind of typical idol boppy, very upbeat tunes. So I'm very keen to see Leela do their own thing and sort of break away from that typical sort of style. In the same way that Muse had songs like Date Date Amujo and Aqua's did, like Aqua's Pirate Desire, those are both very distinctive songs and some of my favourites. So I'm looking forward to whatever's going to become my favourite song for Leela. The outro is very cute. I really like the animation style they've done for it. I also saw that on Twitter before actually seeing the episode. The song's cute. I don't really gravitate towards the slower songs, but they're good to break up all of the more fast-paced songs. Another thing that I really like about this world is the development of school idols as a concept. A lot of the characters in Muse had never heard of school idols before. It was a new concept, it was a fresh idea. But now in Leela, I've got to stop crunching my chair into my desk. In Leela, we see characters that know and understand idols. A good example of that is Kanon's family. Like, they both know exactly what Kanon and Tang are talking about and are able to react in really dramatic ways as a result. And it's very cool to see. It's really nice that we've got this timeline progression, and I'm still holding out for the Muse and Aqua's references. I am sure that they're going to happen. If we assume that in this modern world of Love Live that school idols are kind of the norm, we saw it a little bit in Aqua, but we can probably expect to see a lot more competition. Like with Muse, pretty much their biggest competition was A-Rise and a couple of other groups that we only saw by name. But in this, in Leela, in Superstar, I think that little slideshow of photos at the end were other idol groups, and it would be really, really cool if we get to meet more than just one. Like, I'm not saying have more than one rival group, I want there to be more to the world. Like, in every Love Live iteration, we focus on the group because there's been so many characters to follow and to flesh out and develop and give episodes to, but now we've only got five, and they can do a lot more with the world with less characters, and I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to seeing what they do, and if we do get to see more idol groups, even if they're just in passing performances, like to see their designs, their outfits, hear the songs that they've got, it fleshes out the world and it gives us so much more depth. I'm very, very keen to see what happens there. And if they do end up just going with like one rival group and not showing any other groups, it's fine. It would just be really cool if they broke away from that pattern. That's about all I've got for episode 2. Episode 3 is coming out next month, so there's going to be a bit of a wait. We'll see how it goes. My assumption is that we'll see Tang and Kanon getting ready for the competition. I don't think they'll come first. I think that it's going to be that very typical plot point of the group tries to do something and then fails, they don't get any votes or whatever the metric of this competition is, and the school, like the principal, will be like, "Oh, but you showed dedication and I can see that you're really passionate about what you do," and she'll let them do the whole idol thing anyway. Ren will get really pissy and that will be cool, and we'll see where it goes from there, probably getting Sumire on board and Chisato, and then Ren. I actually think Chisato will join before Sumire, but we'll see.